I'm Terry, and I just discovered I'm a fixer. Just the other day, my wife and I are having a discussion, and I'm saying something about people, and she says to me, "You realize you may be coming across negative to people, and people don't like to be around negative energy." So I started thinking about it. I was driving to work, and then I thought, okay, I'll do some soul searching. I went back to my single-digit years. I think it was around grade one. I grew up in a small rural town of 400 people. Our kitchen table had the basics of necessity, an AM radio and a couple of catalogs. Two of the catalogs were my favorite because they were hardware catalogs. And I loved them because they had pictures of all the different things that people can use around their yards, around their farms, inside their houses, like pumps, lights. And they had sketches, pictures. And I used to study those as I was having breakfast. And I can't remember how long I went. Every day I'd sit there and I'd look through the same ones. Some I'd figure out right away, but other ones I wouldn't. But that's okay, because it kept on going. That was my earliest design into engineering of how things work, how they come together. Fast forward to the college years, and I graduate from tech college, get my first job in a industrial manufacturing plant, making electronic modules. You test them and you put them through a production line. But because the plant was so small, we got a chance to fix the stuff that didn't work. And that was great because I put my electronics theory to use. And when it came through and I was able to fix something, wow, what a confidence builder that was. Fast forward a little bit more into my career. Now I'm in a 20-year stretch of designing circuit boards, electronic circuit boards, 12, 14, 18 layers. Like a sandwich. It's like three-dimensional chess. When you first come into the design, you've got several hundred parts, several thousand connections, and a big rat's nest. It took me most of those 20 years to realize that what I do good at, what I do well there, is looking at patterns, relationships. You look at it, and you find out the parts that work together, the ones that have all the wires close between them, they have to sit beside each other, recognizing patterns. Parallel to this, I got involved with this organization you may have heard called Toastmasters. Well, the thing in Toastmasters is you give speeches. Then a member gives you feedback of how you can get better. And after a while, I started to realize that I'm not really getting good constructive feedback. Why is that? It's the feedback I need to get better. Then I realized one day, that's the feedback I may never hear. That's the feedback you may never hear. Then I started to realize with people and relationships that if something happens once, it's an occurrence. If it happens two, three times, it's a pattern. If it continues, it's a wake-up call. If you don't like the results, you have to go back and change something in the process, something that you do up front that you may not know about because that's the feedback you may never hear. So you have to do something and then analyze the pattern. Do you like the response? Like with people relationships, do you like the response? If not, then you have to go back and try something else. Try something else, something different with people to give you the results you want. Now, believe me, I love successes, celebrating things that work out just like anyone here. But as my wife said once, you know, you always focus in on the things that are broken, the things that are maybe negative. And I says, yeah, but that's great. It's done. It's taken care of. It works. I want to focus on the things that need fixing, things that could be made better, more efficient, more fun, easier to do, whatever it may be. I'm a fixer, and that's what I love to do. I love looking at processes. I like looking at relationships, and I like to see how can I fix it and make it better. My name is Terry, and I am a fixer.